Hello, everyone. Welcome back to my kitchen. Today is Tuesday, so that means yesterday was Monday. And yesterday was going to be a makeover Monday. It was going to be a redo, actually. From 2 Mondays ago, I am still working on trying to get these hot cocoa bombs to work. So yesterday was also National Irish Coffee Day, I believe it was. So my plan was to make a hot cocoa bomb, but also make a chocolate bomb that had the Irish cream in it, or, you know, Bailey's. That's what we were going to do. And I finally did do the cocoa bomb, and I got the powder to stay in it. But putting liquid in one of these things, if it had the tiniest crack, it leaked out. So the problem that I really have been having is that I really wanted to do it in a heart shape. I think if I would have had a sphere, because my daughter said, go watch Emmy. If you guys know Emmy in Japan, she's like my idol. And I watched her video and I said, that's exactly how I'm doing it. I just have a different mold. So again, I'm convinced it is the mold and not me. So I ordered some more heart molds, and they are still, all I've been able to find on Amazon is a heart mold like this big, that's like a diamond heart, and smaller ones like this, you know, like this big. I have not been able to find any that are like the size that I want for hot cocoa bombs. So anyway, I'm still working on that, but we're going to do it. We are going to do it. I'm going to master that. We're going to make a hot cocoa bomb. We're going to make a bomb that has the Bailey's in it. And we're also going to make one that has like candy in it as soon as I find like the right mold. Anyways, today I've got a really cool tip to show you guys on how to clean your waffle maker. But before I get started, if this is your first time here, you love food and fun. I love food and fun. I really love food, but I love fun too. And if you love the same thing, hit the subscribe button as well as the notification bell and check the description below, because you can find some details on how subscribing helps to feed the hungry. Okay, so today I am making some cinnamon rolls in my waffle maker because this is like one of my favorite things to make in here. Actually, it's probably my son's like favorite thing for me to make in here. So simple. So you can do this like the cinnamon rolls, the pumpkin rolls. They have strawberry rolls and orange rolls now, anything like that. And if you watched not too long ago, I did a whole thing on things that you could do in a waffle maker. So if you missed that video, I'll put a link to that right up here in the corner. But yeah, you just throw them in here for just a second. And even though we're doing these all individually, I think I might have messed this one up. They're still quicker than like heating the oven and putting, you know, spreading them out and cooking all of them in there. I think it's really, really quick. All right, let's see. Is he done yet? I think that's good enough. So I'm going to go ahead and take this out. I'm going to put him over here. And while they're hot, I'm going to go ahead and drizzle my, well, that one got a lot of icing, a whole bunch of icing. That's probably good enough. My son's probably going to eat the whole thing by himself. Anyway, so the next thing we want to do to clean the waffle maker is we want to go ahead and make sure it is turned off or unplugged. And then we're going to take a paper towel and we're going to dunk it in some water. So you want it wet, but you don't want it like, you know, wringing wet. We want to kind of wring it out just a little bit so it's more or less damp, I guess. And, ooh, it's sizzling. I'm just going to take my paper towel. I got to say, this waffle maker is pretty darn easy to clean. I'll put a link to this one in the description below because I love it. It's that, like the copper. So we're just going to set our paper towel. We're going to cook our paper towel. I'm going to close it for just a few minutes. And I just leave it in here until it has stopped steaming for the most part. I mean, there's still going to be a little bit of steam in there. And then I just take my paper towel out, and this steam just does wonders. So then I just take a dry paper towel, and we just go in and we wipe it just a little bit. And just be careful. It's still going to be a tiny bit hot, but it's going to be so much easier to clean after you've put that paper towel in there. Look at that. Like I said, this one's pretty easy to clean anyway, but this is great if you've got stuck on batter or anything like that. Works wonders, I do believe. So anyway, I hope that's very helpful for you guys. I thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys tomorrow. Tomorrow's going to be Wednesday, and I think we're going to make some sort of chocolate swirl, like a cake bomb. Even though I have not been having the best of luck with bombs lately, so we'll try it. We'll see what happens. Anyway, I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye.